What does an air traffic controller do?
Air traffic controllers ensure the safety of the routes an aircraft takes. This means they make sure there is enough space between multiple aircraft, aircraft and obstacles, or an aircraft and a vehicle respectively, so they can eliminate the collision and proximity risks in advance. The space of the airport and airway is limited, so if we make the distance between the aircraft far without any clear standard, it will be chaos, right? That is why we need someone who can guide, sequence, and monitor the routes so the aircraft can safely navigate within confined spaces in the most efficient way. The people who play this role are air traffic controllers.
Where does an air traffic controller work at?
Air traffic controllers work at the tower, apron control tower, radar approach facility, and area control center. Among these, the tower and apron control are located only inside the airport, whereas the approach facility and area control center are located outside the airport in many cases. They are called tower controllers and radar controllers respectively. Although they all work for aviation safety, each has a respective sector, working location, and task. If you want to know more, please refer to the tower controller versus radar controller video we made.
Isn't it scary working in the control tower?
Working here for a long time leaves me unaware that I'm sitting on a high place. But I get scared when there's an earthquake or strong wind.
How do you give control instructions to the pilot?
Each aircraft is assigned with its own call sign. Using this call sign, air traffic controllers call an aircraft in one sector and instruct its altitude, speed, heading, etc. Then the pilot reads back the controller's instruction and carries it out. The pilot can call the controller first and tell them the requirements as well. This is called radio communication between the controller and the pilot. Through this radio communication, the controller gives control instructions to the pilot, and all the instructions must follow the established rules and separation method. Vertical separation is when they place the aircraft at a different altitude. Lateral separation is when they place them horizontally apart. Longitudinal separation is when they use the units of time or miles. And visual separation is when the pilot or controller visually sees the aircraft involved. Based on such methods and detailed rules, the controller makes the best decision every moment and decides which separation is suitable for each aircraft. Isn't it really cool to think that my decision and words make the traffic order on the sky road?
Does an air traffic controller always get on the flight for free?
Of course not.
Nope.
How do you become an air traffic controller?
Becoming an air traffic controller varies depending on the country. However, generally, you need to graduate with a related major or complete the air traffic controller training course by the government-designated educational institution to be eligible to take the controller recruitment exam. Moreover, there are many cases where they use their experience of working as an air traffic controller in the military and become a civilian controller. Try searching the qualifications for a controller in your country. Let's share it with everyone in the comments.
What's the requirement of physical condition?
The eyes and ears of an air traffic controller are very important for flight safety. If you hear sounds or read the numbers on the radar display incorrectly, this can lead to fatal accidents immediately. Therefore, a controller must receive physical examinations regularly even after meeting the controller qualifications. Blood, blood pressure, lung capacity, electrocardiography, nose, ear, throat, hearing, eyesight, etc. will be tested. For example, if you are severely colorblind, it will be hard to pass the exam. And many countries limit the age to under 30 when hiring a newcomer. Of course, each country has different requirements, so be sure to check the qualifications in your country.
Are English and math mandatory to be an air traffic controller?
Having good English and mathematical skills does not mean being a good controller. However, the basic English and math sense is a must. All the controllers and pilots' conversations are in English, but communication problems that cannot be solved by the air traffic control phraseology often occur, so the native level is not a must, but basic listening and speaking will be needed. Therefore, air traffic controllers involved in international operations are required to attain the ability to speak and understand English to a level 4 proficiency on ICAO's Language Proficiency Rating Scale.
Do air traffic controllers work shifts?
Yes. Air traffic control service is provided 24 hours, 365 days a year. Therefore, most air traffic control facilities do schedule work. Rosters are prepared for air traffic controllers several months in advance, and each controller will share a working day, evening, and night shift, as well as weekends and public holidays.
Is it impossible to sleep during the night shift?
The bottom line is that the air traffic controller can sleep during the night shift. It doesn't mean that the controller can sleep anytime, anywhere. The late night traffic load is usually less than in the daytime, so it is not necessary to have many people. Each person decides what time to have a break in turn. The controller can sleep in the separate rest area, not in the control room. But you shouldn't expect it to be as comfortable as though you slept at home. It's more accurate to say that you stand by in another place than sleep, because there can be various unpredictable and urgent situations. We are getting ready to run to the control room as soon as we get a call. Despite the break, you often miss the time to sleep and even stay up all night. In conclusion, although there is time and space to sleep, the night shift is tiring. However, plenty of break after the night shift is an appealing payback for withstanding the sleepless night.
When do you feel most proud or worthwhile to be an air traffic controller?
The control facilities are not a space where anyone can come in, so it's special that the air traffic controller goes to work to a control room. And when I introduce my job to others as an air traffic controller, 99% of people react like, "Wow, that's cool." This is the moment I feel lucky to be an air traffic controller. The most rewarding time is when handling the dangerous situation, doing my best. For instance, when my control helps an aircraft during emergency landing to safely land, or when I turn the complicated traffic into safe status, a controller feels satisfaction and pride. Also, when the pilot gives thanks for my control, this little gratitude means the world to the air traffic controller.
Do they have occupational diseases or unique habits of controllers?
Of course. When we arrive at a particular place, we check from the east, west, north, and south directions first. And when we have a conversation, we always try to get a definite response and read back from the other person. In our The Real Life of Air Traffic Controllers video, you can see the relatable habits of controllers that only real controllers can feel. It's really fun, so don't forget to check out that video.
Are you sitting at the control seat all day?
Absolutely not. That is very dangerous behavior. There is a certain limitation to human focus. If he or she tries to control without break time, then it will negatively affect flight safety. Controllers are repeating the routine of a certain time of work and rest. During break time, we do things like web surfing, drinking coffee, reading a book, and doing some paperwork. In short, controllers take turns taking breaks during office hours.
How much do you earn?
The salary varies from country to country and depends on insurance, allowances, and benefits. Usually, the more experienced receive a higher salary. And even within the same country, an air traffic controller who works in a busy area with high traffic gets paid more than one in a leisurely place. In the US, the median annual wage for air traffic control specialists is $138,556 in 2021. Wages vary slightly from state to state, but in the United States, the highest paying job that does not require a four-year degree is a traffic controller. The licensed tower controllers in Canada earn between $81,000 and $165,000, and the ACC controllers earn a little more. In the UK, new controllers earn from £39,002 to £43,469 after passing a training course, and experienced controllers could potentially earn over £100,000, including shift pay.
What do you think is the mandatory ability for the controller?
Many people think that air traffic controllers have high IQs and are good at English and maths. However, if the person can pass the controller exam and is proven capable, the more important abilities considered are effective communication skills, quickly distinguishing priority of work in a complex situation, and service mind for the opposite side. Teamwork ability and calmness under the pressure of crises are also important qualities.
Will you become an air traffic controller again if you have another chance to choose your job?
Of course, yes. Well, I've never thought about a job other than a controller. I really like being a person who's responsible for the safety of the sky. Don't forget that controllers are always with you when you travel by plane. We are here for you. ATC for you.